cold here.
Chronicler? Are you there? I've done what you've asked of me, but I'm afraid I'm lost.
As long as the spirits of the ancestors are with you, you are never lost. Calm yourself, Spyro, and cool your thoughts. Do not let your fire control you. There are other elements at play here. The power of ice also moves through you, just as the chilled winds whip through your wings. Let it expand. I knew you'd remember. Life seeks out balance, young dragon. And one who can master fire and ice is truly powerful in the shifting face of danger.
What's up, Internet? This is Random Game Critic, and welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Spyro the Eternal Knight. In the last episode, we began our journey through the ancient grove, the creepy forest of awesomeness, and we got lost. So now we're back into another trippy dream segment where we now learn the ice breath. I'm sure you've all noticed, the elements that we learn are in a different order in this game. Another thing you'll notice is that the ice breath in this game is also different as well. So, last time it was fire, electricity, ice, and earth. This time it's fire, then ice, and then don't know what the order is after that. Well, I mean, obviously I do, but whatever. So this deck is different. You fire port... I actually didn't get to demonstrate very clearly there, because I just kept them blowing up enemies and the ice effects were covering the screen. Let me give you a better look at that. You press square and you fire a polar bomb. It's like a little ice bomb. Simple enough. You hold it down, and it fires farther. I'm not sure if it's stronger, though. I don't think it is. Anywho, one thing that I should mention, because I actually just recently realized this. Okay, press triangle to use the ice tail attack. Also different. I just recently realized, I should have known this all along, but Spyro's fire breath, like the typical just square to use Spyro's fire breath, that is the one elemental attack that is unchanged in this game. Everything else has been changed and modified. The ice breath is different, the secondary ice deck is different. Everything but the primary fire breath has been changed. Which, I don't like or dislike that. It's just a change, and I always try to be more open-minded with changes, because, I don't get time to rant about this. As much as I enjoy being philosophical and explaining to you guys the way that I think and my opinions and whatnot, that's not what you guys are here for. You're here to watch me play this game. And hopefully have funny stuff happen in the meantime. But probably not. More seesaws. Ow, I just crashed into nothing. And ran out of dragon time. No matter, though, I made it anyway. Now here's a very interesting gimmick here. Polar bombs. Well, I'll just let you read this while I admire the scenery. Like I've said it a million times before, the graphics in this game, even in the ancient grove, the graphics are always really cool. Anyways, hold square. Well, you can just press square also, but it makes a solid ice platform. Pretty simple. But what's interesting is the fact that you actually are required to use magic at certain points in this game, and I'll explain more about that later. But for now, though. Oh, before I forget, I should update my backup file. See, it says Dream now. I'm in a different segment of the game. I'm going to update my backup file because I do not want to play through the Ancient Grove for a fifth time should I screw up something in the next leg of the game. And yeah, I said five. It took me three recording attempts to get to collect everything in the Ancient Grove segment, and then I had to play through that entire thing again to get back to this point. Yeah, believe it or not, well, I'm sure if you go back and watch the episode again, you'll notice that the game never saved once throughout the entire last episode, so I had to play the whole thing over again. Did it pretty quickly, though. I mean, if I'm not trying to explain stuff and, if I'm not stopping to explain things, then it took me, 5 minutes to get through the whole thing. Very short. And this episode's gonna be really short as well, and I apologize, but I just like to have my videos broken up into solid, discernible segments. This game labels the areas of the game. And I want to split up my videos as such. Just the way that the game splits them up. That's just the way that it feels right to me, no matter how short some of them are. I'm not sure how many of you still remember my old Spyro the Dragon Let's Play. whenever we got to the final world of the game, the Nork Nexus. Some of the videos were 30 seconds long because I'm like, okay, this is part 3 of the Nork Nexus hub world. I broke open a single chest, then concluded the episode and went on to the next level. Because I went on to a different level. I'm very weird like that. Anyway, let's stop explaining and stop taking damage and use the Ice Fury, which is much cooler looking. Much cooler looking. Again, the Matrix-y effect is kind of weird, but whatever. It's still pretty awesome. And there we go. We are already done here. So yes, the last episode was short. This episode was pretty short as well. But in the next episode, we're going to be going back to the forest. Well, hopefully you're back in the forest. We don't even know where Spyro is right now. The pirates may have taken him, for all we know. But we don't know yet. Anyways, in the next episode, we're going to continue our quest to look for that tree, find the chronicler, and hopefully get some answers. See you guys then. God, slow down.
Okay, now what? What is it you want me to do? I think I'm entitled to know what's happening.
You already know what is happening.
No, we don't!
The great evil that is awakening. But there is more that you must understand.
I've seen this place before. It frightens me.
This is an evil place, Spyro. It is called the Mountain of Malifor. Asylum to the wandering phantoms and lost spirits of those who had turned to darkness. But to the spirits themselves and the black-hearted, it goes by another name.
The Well of Souls.